This is part 3 of roof floor plan jam arrangement drawing. In our previous tutorial, we duplicated the first floor jam arrangement drawing for the roof floor jam arrangement drawing, and we made a lot of edits. In this tutorial, our main objective will be to draw the section drawing for the roof floor plan jam arrangement drawing. This section in the vertical direction and the section in the horizontal direction. In our previous tutorial, we forgot to place slab labels for this panel and this panel. I'm going to quickly do that now by selecting this slab label information here and copying to this region. I'll do the same thing for this region. But the slab panel in the horizontal direction is too long, so I'll make some edits. I will select the panel arrow in the horizontal direction. I'll move it inside. Do the same thing here. Move it inside. So let me delete this, and I'll rotate this and create it again. Rotate, make a copy, type C, enter. So I've denoted the two panel with the span arrow tag and the thickness information, the tag that for the that specify the thickness of the panel. So our last section, this is section AA. Section AA and section BB. In our the last section we created are section II and section JJ, IJK. So our next section will be K. So I'll change this A to K. Change this to L. So that's KK. This will be LL. This will be LL. Now, so this section, I'm going to work on section KK first. So I'll change this heading here to section KK. I'm going to delete all this except the structural grid. At grid line A for section KK, we have a beam. Grid line A, we have a 2 by 750 beam, and we also have roof gutter to the after it. We have a 230 by 750 D beam, so I'm going to draw that 230 by 750 beam on our section now. So 230, I'll draw it. 230. And I will enter D on my keyboard for dimension. So 230, type 230 by 750 D beam. So this is the beam. I'm going to move this from the center of the rectangle here to say somewhere here. So we have our beam elements here. What I'll do now, I will zoom to the architectural design where we have the profile of the roof. So in my architectural design here, section AA, we can get our proposed slope of the roof. This line is at 5% slope, so I'm going to copy it. Remember, we plan to locate our beam along this wall. So I'm going to copy the profile line of the roof using this base point here. And I will paste at this point of the beam. So this is our profile line for the roof. So what I'm going to do now, at the line B, C, and E from our drawing, at the line B, the beam is a 230 by 600 beam. So this beam is a 230 by 600. At the line C, this beam is a 230. The beam here is a 230 by 600 deep beam. At the line E is also a 230 by 600 D beam. What I'm going to do, I'm going to use my rectangular tool and I will So the 230 by 600 dB, enter D on my keyboard. So 230 by 600. So this is the 230 by 600. I'm going to copy the rectangle, duplicate it at this point here. At this point here. I can't duplicate at this point. However, for grid line E, I would like to zoom to my architectural section drawing. You know, I copied this profile line earlier, and this profile line is starting at the edge of the wall. So my beam, says the profile line connects to my beam at this edge. So I'm going to copy this beam and paste at this point. So this will be the location of my beam on the section drawing. I would like you to know something. The profile I'm drawing now is just an approximation. It approximates the 5% slope. You cannot get accurate slope with a beam slab structural floor. For you to get an accurate flow, accurate slope for this floor, we have to use a flat roof. But we're not using a flat roof, I'm using a beam slab type. So what I'm going to, so I will, you will see what I'm talking about now. I'll use my line command. I will draw a line from here to the edge of this beam. Press escape to end command. You can see the line I just drew is different from the slope line. It differs a bit by like 5-6 mm. But it's an approximation of the slope line. I'll do the same thing between the line B and C. I will use the line command. I'll draw a line from the edge of this beam to the edge of this beam. I'll do the same thing from the edge of this beam to the edge of this beam. Then I will delete my slope line, my proposed slope profile. This is what we have at the end of the day. So this is the profile I will use in my design for my floor. The line shows the top of my structural roof floor. So our roof thickness is 230. So I'm going to select this line and I'll offset it down by 200, because our thickness of the roof is 200. I'll do the same thing for this. I'll offset it down by 200. Offset it down by 200. So if you look at the drawing, I need to extend this line to this beam. Here I need to trim. I need to extend here. So I'll use the trim command, trim extend command on my ribbon, on the modify tab of my ribbon. This is a trim command. So when you click on the trim command, you can execute trim and extend at the same time. After you click on the trim command on the modify panel, press enter on your keyboard. Then you can move from trim to extend by holding down the shift key. If I don't hold down the shift key, that means I'm trimming. If I should hold down the shift key, I'm extending the line. I hold down the shift key and I place my cursor there. You see the line extend. So hold down the shift key, click on the line. I've extended the line. I want to trim this region. I'm not pressing the shift key, so I'm in trim mode. So I'm trimming. I hope you understand my explanation on the use of trim and extend command in AutoCAD. So do the same thing here. I will trim. Here I will extend and trim. I will trim, extend and trim. I will trim. So this is the profile. This is section AA, section KK for the roof floor plan. But it still remains one component, the roof gutter. So from our previous story, I told you that the bottom slab is lowered down 600 mm, that is 1.6 meter. We also have the section line is also cutting the beam along the line A1. So I'm going to draw that in our section. So What I'm going to do here, I'm going to select this object and I'm going to explode it so that I'm going to explode it so it consists of just line segments. So I've used the explode command to break the component down. So here now I will I told you that the width, the overall width of the roof gutter is 920, as shown here. The width of the roof gutter is 920 mm. So I'm going to tap to the next dimension here, the 127. So I'll enter my 920. I will draw a line from this point upwards 750. The width of the beam is 190, 600 down to 500, yeah. I'm going to move this. So this is the section with the roof gutter. This is how it's going to look like. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to select all the components, the line segments, and I'm going to join them together using the join command. I've selected all the components. I will type join, J-O-I-N, and press enter to join component together. But it didn't join everything. So what you do, you select what was joined and select the other components again. Click on, you type join again, enter, select. So now it's okay. What I'll do now, I'll apply the blue color to this object, select it, right click, property, color, blue. Then I will apply the concrete ash to the segment. Concrete ash to the segment. So change the density of the ash to 2. Okay, like this. So this is our section KK. There is an information that you need to specify on this drawing so you can model this on the Orion18 software. You need to model, you need to specify the elevation of all your beams. How you do that? I'll draw a line from this point, an horizontal line. So this horizontal line represents my elevation of my roof floor plan. But I plan to raise some of the structural components a bit upward. So this elevation here, let me copy this. The elevation of the beam here is 18, is what is here, 18 plus 4 to 5. So 18 plus 4, 4 to 5. The elevation of this beam here will be raised a bit. You have to determine distance from this intersection to the top of the beam. So I'm using my measure command. Measure. This is 354.25. So I'll use my calculator. So I've forgotten the value that I just measured. Sorry. Use the measure command again. 352.25. So what you are going to do, I'm going to add 354.25. You add 18425 plus 354.25. This will give you 18 plus 779. I will I will throw away this 0.25 because it's not important. I'll throw away the 0.25. My unit of measurement is to nearest 1 mm. So this 18, I'll make it 18780. 18780. I'll copy this 18780. I'll move this, put it here. 18780. 780. I would like to change the height of the text. Select the text property. Change the height to say 200, 150. Also change this text to 150 and I'll move it. I'll close the property tab, copy this elevation tag, I'll put it here and I'll also put it here. However, I need to calculate, I need to measure from this point to this point. I didn't paste, I didn't position this properly. So I need to measure from this elevation to this elevation. 4, 2, 3. So 18, 4, 2, 5 plus 4, 2, 3. 4, 2, 3. We have 18,848. I'll do the same thing to this label. I'll measure from this elevation to the top of the beam. 693.5. So you may 693.5 18,425 plus 6,935.5 equals to 19,119. I'm going to select this. Position it properly. 19,119. Remember in my section drawing, I don't use plus. So I'll put, change everything to points. I did this, remove the plus, change it to points. Do the same thing for this point. So I've done our section KK. It's also desirable to determine the elevation of the beam at D for the roof floor plan. We've determined the elevation of our beam at A, B, C, and E. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to place a section at this point. So the KLM, and I will name it section M. Now I will quickly draw the section MM by editing the section KK drawing. So this is section KK. I'll copy it downward, duplicate it downward, change the section to MM. The section KK, section MM is identical to KK, just that it does not have section EE. It does not have grid line E. The grid line is A, B, C, D, as shown in the plan here. A, B, C, D. So, and C is 4.24 meters from D. So I'm going to duplicate this structural grid. I'll copy it 4.24 meters to my right hand side. I will delete this grid. I'm going to place this beam. Is it a 230 by 600 beam? Let me measure it. Okay, 230 by 600 beam. I'll copy it. And I'll put it at this point here. I need my profile line on the architectural drawing again. I'll copy using this base point. I'll put it here. So copy the move the my beam line. I'll position it at the grid intersection and my profile line. So this is where I'm positioning my beam at structural grid D. So I don't need the profile line again. I'm going to delete it because I positioned my beam. I'm going to explode this one object. Use the explode command. Type explode on your keyboard. Press enter. So I've exploded the objects. The object now consists of line. I want to move this line connecting this and the beam at C and the beam at this point. I want to move it here. I don't need this line. I will move the hash pattern. I don't need this again. I'm going to offset this down by 200. Use the offset command, offset that line by 200. We didn't know the thickness of the slab. I'll use the trim command to to make some edits. Same command, I think it's okay now. So I'll move this elevation tag, I'll move it here. You take your measurements from the baseline elevation to this point. This is 635.5. So use your calculator, 18.425. Plus 635.5. This is I didn't press the values properly on my calculator. 18.425 plus 635.5. So this is 19,060. I enter 19,060 here. So this is what we have here, 19,060. So I'll change this, this blue, I'll apply this blue color to the black line here. And I will select all the line segments and join it together. I'll use the join command, type join on your screen. I'll repeat the process again because it didn't join all the components for me together. I will type join. Join. And I will fill my object with the concrete hash pattern. Press escape to end command. Okay. Now I'll delete this rectangle. Also delete this and this. So in this tutorial, we'll draw section KK and section MM. Okay. The section LL is identical. It's similar. I'll just make a little edit on this drawing for section LL. So section LL, I will change the heading to LL. The structural elevation. The structural elevation. Assuming this section line is located at the center of of the line AB. I will know that AB is 7200. That is so from using major command from this grid line to this grid line is 7200. So assuming it's located at the center 3600. So it means that I'm trying to determine the elevation of the floor at LL when the section line is at the center of this panel. So, assume I draw a vertical line down and I move it, okay, not from here, from the grid line, and I move it 3.6 meters, 3600 to the right. So the vertical line from this intersection to the top of the slab is my elevation at this point. So I'm going to use the major command to determine this value. It's 177.125. Say 177. So I'm going to add. I'm going to calculate the elevation at 18425 plus 177. 18602. So I'll delete all this. I don't need again. 18602 is my elevation for section LL. 18602. 18.602. So you can see this section LL, my beam along section LL are all 600. Also, my beam are 600 by 230. The outstand beam is 500. The next slab is 200. So I've come to the end of this tutorial. We have completely drawn the roof floor plan joint arrangement drawing. With this drawing, the contractor is provided with all the information to set out this roof. In our next tutorial, we're going to look at joint arrangement for the staircase, the half-turn staircase, and the quarter-turn staircase. Thank you for watching the tutorial.